name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit, and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous. Although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall I compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that, when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. First, I will sate your curiosity. You may have noticed we have a friar in our midst. The said friar is Brother Lance Love. He is on his way with a food truck for their ministry down in Los Angeles, right? So pray for him to have safe travels. Lance is actually from here in Utah, so we have vocations among us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What is the kingdom of God? That's quite a question. And many of our Lord's parables deal with it. And in fact, much of St. Paul's writing deals with this, as does the writing of many of the saints. That's why our Lord speaks in parables, to describe what the kingdom of God is like. So we should ask ourselves, what is the kingdom of God? Well, there are many answers, because the kingdom of God, being a divine reality, is somewhat hard to put a handle on. In one sense, you could say that everything that is God's kingdom. And that would be true, because the Lord is Lord of all creation. He created everything. This universe and any other universe there might be. And so you could say that the kingdom of God is all that is, because he made it and he keeps it in existence. Or you could say that the kingdom of God is heaven, that it consists of God and the angels, of the saints and the saints, those who enjoy the beatific vision. Could say that the kingdom of God is the New Jerusalem, which is described in glorious detail in the book of Revelation. The New Jerusalem from which life-saving grace pours out into the world. And yet, as you know, heaven is not yet on earth, and we are not in heaven yet. We hope to be there, but it is yet to be fulfilled. And you could also say that the kingdom of God is the church, that the church is God's kingdom here on earth. And that would be right, because we are taught that our Holy Mother, the Church, is the embryonic form of the New Jerusalem, the childhood of heaven. And what this reminds us of is that God is in charge, that the Church is not ours, it is God's. And we are just stewards. And this is one of the reasons why we can't alter things to suit our fancy. We can't say, you know, that sacrament of matrimony, that's a pain, so let's just have six sacraments, rather. Or we need another sacrament, bingo or donuts, so that we would have eight sacraments. No, we don't get to alter things to suit our fancy, because the Church is God's, and it is God's kingdom, and we obey him, and we follow him. This is why the Lord speaks about it in parables, because it is a divine reality, and as such, we can't really encompass it easily by talking about it in one way or the other. He speaks about it in parables, in figures. And one of the figures that we have today is this of a field. So the kingdom of God is like a field where a man goes out and he scatters the seeds. And what happens with the seeds? They grow. And pretty soon he has a field of wheat. And as soon as it's ready, it is harvested. The kingdom of God is like that. Because God himself plants the seeds of grace, and they grow. And on the day of judgment, the angels will come, and they will harvest. Or the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. Who here has ever seen a mustard seed? I have two. One of our teachers at the seminary, she was a great lady, even though we called her Tiny Tim, because she was Sister Mary Timothy and she was very short, so Tiny Tim. And one of the things she did in class is she passed around a little vial with a mustard seed in it, tiny, tiny thing. And yet, as the scripture tells us, you plant the mustard seed and it grows into something marvelous and beautiful. So too with God's grace, God plants the seed and it grows into something entirely different. My sons and daughters in Christ, the kingdom of God is here, and yet it is not complete. It will only be complete when the Lord returns in glory at the end of time to judge the heavens and the earth and the world by fire. We are part of the kingdom of God, and yet we are not all of it, because it is not about us, it is about God. And we look forward to the fulfillment of the kingdom of God, because we look forward to our salvation. We look forward to the new heaven and the new earth when we shall gaze upon God face to face. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who hath spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now raise our voices in prayer for the needs of the church and the world.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Bishop Oscar, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, those who care for the sick, and all those affected by the pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our civil leaders will govern in accord with the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That fallen away and apostate Catholics will return to Christ's church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we will be blessed with an increase in vocations to the religious life, diaconate, and priesthood, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection of our country and the safety of our military forces and first responders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of all the poor souls in purgatory, especially those most in need of our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God, who places value on the smallest of his creatures, may renew in our hearts an active love and reverence for all children, born and unborn, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own intention that we add in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty and ever-living Father, look with kindness upon these prayers which we offer in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Mary Ann Murray. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his Paschal mystery he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your Holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith, remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mysterium Fidei. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
At this time, while we're unable to approach our Lord's altar in our church, in faith, we make a spiritual act of communion as we pray, "My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen."
Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in this day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, and for an end to the drought, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.